What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over Entity Wizard, a plugin for Blockbench. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give the video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every video we upload, just like this one. Many modders in Minecraft make their own custom entities for their projects, leading to some wonderful creations, such as ice and fire dragons. This isn't going to take a lot of time, energy, or skill to learn. Mojang has even partnered with Blockbench, an easy-to-use model program that any player can use for free. This partnership resulted in the Minecraft Entity Wizard, a plugin for the application Blockbench, which allows people to create items, mobs, or blocks. And you don't even have to know how to code to use this. You can make your own custom Minecraft mods, animals, or characters for free. Installation is also super easy. Before making your custom game assets, installing Blockbench and Minecraft Entity Wizard is required. Otherwise, you can use the online version so you don't even have to download anything. It's encouraged to use the program instead of the website, but do whatever you want. You're gonna go ahead and jump over to the Blockbench download page and then choose a package that matches your operating system. Once installed, you can run the program if it hasn't already opened. Then in the application, go ahead and click on files in Blockbench on the top left, and then click on plugins. Afterward, you can just look up Minecraft Entity Wizard in the search field or scroll until you find it. Then press install. And that's it. You've installed everything required to get started. We're not going to show you how exactly to use Blockbench in this video, but we're going to recommend that you check out their wiki page or Microsoft Blockbench guide. They made their own guide on how to use Blockbench, and it's pretty useful. But there are also a ton of great videos made by awesome creators on how to use Blockbench. To get started with using Entity Wizard, you're going to go ahead and click on Tools, and then click on Minecraft Entity Wizard. This opens the menu for the entities, which is going to require you to fill out some information. Once filled, just click on Next at the bottom and select a mob appearance for the entity. Afterwards, you can continue to alter its behavior, and you can keep it the same, or you can choose another mob for its in-game actions. On the next prompt, you're gonna select the spawn egg as you see fit by changing the colors or by adding your own custom texture. And when that's completed, you can head to the export section and choose the folder or MC add-on options. You're gonna be able to enter your pack name and put in your name as the author or add in your own pack icon. And then you can just click on export. You can also click on Edit Model on the Next Step section, and everything is going to be prepared for you to start making your own entity. There's a ton of features you can use in Minecraft Entity Wizard, which can be overwhelming. Every entity can appear to and even act differently, such as villagers having zombie behaviors. This can allow for some interesting creations and endless possibilities, especially with custom models. Sadly, due to the vast amount of features and functionality, we can't really review every detail. However, there are a lot of general guidelines and videos to follow and information to understand as you develop your project. For one, there's textures. Players view and interact with the entity's textures in-game, making this an essential aspect to the program. Customizing them can result in some entertaining mobs or blocks and can be suspicious sometimes. Once a model's appearance is selected, there is a predefined area for textures, which can be completely configured to your liking. Anyone can start editing textures in the built-in paint mode or an external program such as Photoshop to change the resource files. It can become a bit confusing as every mode changes the entity's editing layout. It also might take some time to really get comfortable with this program or even master it, but that comes with experience as you start making your own custom models. An important part of Blockbench though is the animations. Once you really get into a stride and know what you're doing on this app, you can control individual areas such as the head or the arm for walking around or hurting the player in game. Textures are going to automatically tailor to animations, so making one part larger increases the visual size for it. The exact process for achieving this is complicated compared to anything else you've done in Minecraft so far, so you are going to need to practice and spend a lot of time getting comfortable with this program. As previously mentioned, the Blockbench program can create entities for all versions of Minecraft. However, it can also be used to create player skins, Optifine models, and modded mobs. Creating custom entities in Minecraft can be tons of fun and really rewarding, but it's also a little bit challenging. But if you're cool and have some extra time, then you can make some of your own custom stuff. Start editing a mob's movement, a block size, or an item's textures through their easy-to-use interface. Becoming an expert at this requires practice and experience, so the earlier you start using Blockbench, the better. Well, folks, we hope this guide helped you learn about Blockbench and how to install it, and even get excited about Entity Wizard. And as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.